Hey, Pascal here again, and in this video I'm talking about the GoPro Hero 6 and the best settings that you need to match the colors with your other cameras, because I had a lot of problems with that in the past, and so I think it can be very beneficial. So I'm on Koh Lanta right now. It's one of my favorite islands in Thailand. Yeah. And what I like here, it's a much nicer place. Like, it's not so overcrowded here, not so busy as Koh Samui or Phuket or Phi Phi Island and so. So I like to go here, and I actually have a video about that here in German. So right now I'm also going to produce a new video in English about that. So stay tuned. But let's go to the topic. So I'm going to talk about the Hero 6 today, but it also counts for the Hero 5 and I think also the Hero 4, at least every GoPro camera that has ProTune, because that's very important. And it's not the usual video that you will find, like, oh, how to set up ProTune, how to set up your ISO and so on. No, I'm going to talk about how to set up the camera to match it with your other cameras, because when I was in Tenerife, I had this problem, especially when I did the hiking on the Mount Teide video, that it was extremely hard to match it with my GH5 and the Phantom 4 Pro and so on. And of course I played a lot around with this camera, with the GoPro Hero 6, to make it possible to match the colors, because on this video, on the hike to the Mount Teide, I was color grading around 3 days just because it was such a pain in the ass to do that. So of course I want to save a lot of time in the future, and I think this tip can save you a lot of time in the future as well. So yeah, let's get straight to the point. I will turn the GoPro Hero 6 on now, because most of the settings you will probably know already from other videos, so there's nothing new, so I will just get through it pretty fast, and then we come to the main setting that's very important. And yeah, just to say it before, it's a native white balance, but going to that later. So of course, at first you should turn on ProTune, and I will just talk about the settings really short. So set the shutter to auto, that's very important. EV compensation, you can set it between 0 and 1.5. It depends. When you have a lot of light going on, the light is pretty flat, then it's probably better to set it to -1, because the GoPro tries to highlight it a bit, and it can look pretty bad with some noise and so on when you have, when you don't have luck. So yeah, right now I set it to 0, because when I was filming here, it was actually a bit too dark to get details in the rocks here. So yeah, that's important. And the other thing is your ISO. ISO is important. Of course, you don't want to get noise. So ISO 100 min, and max ISO should be 400 maximum. I usually use 200 when I film over the day, but right now also it was better to use ISO 400. Also, when you film with 60 frames per second, it also makes sense to use ISO 400, because you need more shutter speed, which lowers the light, and then the camera has a bit more options to adjust that via the ISO. The next setting is the sharpness, and I have my sharpness all the time too low, because digital cameras tend to over sharpen it all the time, also the GoPro. And I would say medium is okay too, but don't set it too high. That's just low or medium, and then you're fine with that. Next thing is the color, of course. Set it to flat. I think you've already seen that in other videos, just to have more options with color grading, of course. So it's also important for matching it with your other cameras. And now let's go to the final one, the white balance. White balance is so important. Like, I was playing around with all the settings on the GoPro, like, for I don't know how long. At first I had the automatic white balance, then I set it manually to make it look a bit better. But the problem is that the white balance of the GoPro is not just affecting the white balance, you can also affect your picture profile, basically. It doesn't look like that in the menu, but when you set it to native white balance, you will recognize, after grading of course, that the colors look much better or more like other cameras. So why is that? What I figured out is that the GoPro, doesn't matter if you use a flat color profile or the normal GoPro color profile, always does something crazy with the colors in the picture. For example, you get a lot more blue in the sky when doing it normally, like with automatic white balance or with a manual white balance. And that's kind of a problem, because especially when you film against the sun, or let's say anywhere around the sun, then on the usual camera you would see a lot of orange tones there, and also like some blues, but a bit less blues than in the GoPro. And in the GoPro you actually see a lot of blues and then this crazy orange sun there, and just a little bit around that. And that makes it very hard to grade, because the colors from the GoPro look so different. And yeah, there's actually this little trick that I said before, just use the native white balance to do that, because for me it looks like then it's not really just about the white balance when you use this option, it's more about the colors itself. So it actually seems like that when you set the white balance normally, like auto or manual white balance, that the GoPro applies its own color profile. It doesn't matter if you use flat or not. And when you use native white balance, it doesn't do that. It takes the picture like they come into the camera, and that makes it easier for you to grade it. Like for example, when I usually match my Phantom 4 Pro or my Mavic Pro footage with the GH5 or the G85 before also, I never had much problems to match those picture profiles, because all the colors were pretty natural and looked pretty much the same. But with the GoPro it wasn't like that, and since I use this native white balance, it becomes a lot easier. So yeah, pretty easy here. Just use the settings that I mentioned in the first part of the video and set your white balance to native, and then you're pretty good to go. And it should be much easier for you to match the colors with your other cameras. It's that simple actually, so I don't want to make such a long video here. If you like this tip, then leave me a thumbs up there on YouTube. And if you want to have more tips like that, then subscribe to my channel, and see you in the next video.